Hi friends, I'm Kazel, and if you don't know it yet, GoodNotes just released a major update to the app, and today I will be sharing with you the new features added in GoodNotes 6, so let's begin. To make sure that the new features are available to you, make sure to update the app first, and you can do that in the App Store. Just search GoodNotes 6. Although GoodNotes says that your notebooks and GoodNotes files are safe during the transition from GoodNotes 5 to GoodNotes 6, it is always better to be safe than sorry, so make sure to create a backup of your files. If you don't know how to do that, you can check this video out, and I will also add the link in the description box below, so make sure to check that out to create some backup copies of your GoodNotes files. Once that is done, let's open the app and you will be prompted to try GoodNotes 6 for free or purchase it through a subscription or a one-time payment. Then you will be prompted to create your GoodNotes account and you can use your Google, Apple, or your Microsoft account, whichever you want to use. And the use of the GoodNotes account is for back-end processing of GoodNotes, for them to know which payment model you are subscribed to, and for some features to be made available to you. And I think this will also be used for syncing between iOS and Windows. The first thing that you will notice once you are signed in is that the interface is a little different, and in the library view, the sections are now on the left. Here is the navigation panel and the document section, favorite section, search, shared, and they have also added the marketplace section. The interface in the library view looks a lot like the files app now, but I don't really mind and I think it's cleaner this way. One of the new features is the customization of folders. You can now change the color and add an icon to the folder. To customize existing folders, tap the downward arrowhead beside the folder name and then select the color that you want. You can also add the icons if you want to. To create a new customized folder, tap the plus icon and select folder. Then set the folder name, then the color, and then the icon. If you don't want the folder to have any icon, you can use the backslash option in the lower right corner. Another new feature is the customization of notebook page templates. You can now create a customized version of the templates provided by GoodNotes. So on the paper template setting for the size, the sizes available in GoodNotes 5 were still available in GoodNotes 6, but the new option here is the custom one. You can now customize the size of the template that you want to use. This is helpful if you have a notebook that you have created or bought somewhere else, and you can now avoid that annoying thing where the pages of your notebook are different when you insert a GoodNotes paper template in between. Once the values are set, you can just tap apply. The other option for the paper template is the color. Open the setting option and select customize template. You can now change the color of the paper template. And depending on the type of paper template you have chosen, there will be different types of color settings available, so make sure to explore the different options. If you're satisfied with the template setting you have created, you can add a name and then apply. You will see your custom template here. And if you want to change the name of the custom theme you just created, tap edit and tap the pencil icon beside the name and then edit. On the other hand, if you want to delete the template, tap edit and then select the ones you want to delete, then tap delete. Once satisfied with the paper template, you can also customize the cover. If you're going to use the cover templates by GoodNotes, the size and color can also be customized similar to the paper templates. There is a bug right now that when you have chosen an imported cover template and you tap the color setting option, you cannot scroll up to the other cover templates available, so you have to cancel and start all over again. This also happens for the paper templates, so I hope they'll solve this one up. The interface in the document view is generally the same as the GoodNotes 5 with the difference on the icon style and the navigation bar. Specifically, these three icons in the center which are called the input modes icon. If none of the three icons are selected, this means that it is currently in the read-only mode. If you have hyperlinks in your notebook, you can use them here. If you want to write and edit your notebook pages, you can tap the pencil icon to activate the edit mode. The toolbar will appear and you can generally use the tools in the same way as in GoodNotes 5. The keyboard icon allows for a full page typing. And the third icon is for audio recording. Once a new recording is available in the notebook, the recording player will appear and you can tap on it to access the audio clips that you have recorded. Another new feature of the app are the new pen gestures that are available. Let's check if they are turned on first. So tap the pen icon in the toolbar and on the pen gestures under setting, turn on all the options. You can now scribble on handwritten notes using the pen to erase them. You can also erase highlights and shapes if you want. But you can turn this off in the pen gesture setting by toggling off the second option. Another pen gesture is the circle to select. You can select handwritten notes by drawing a circle around them and then tap, hold, then drag the selection. Let's go back to the pen option, and as you can see, there is this new option called Writing Aids. To use this, set the correct recognition language first, and to turn on the spell checker feature, toggle on the check spelling option. This enables the detection of misspelled words and it will correct them. GoodNotes will attempt to mimic your handwriting style and use this to write the words in the correct spelling. Another writing aid option is the word complete. This is currently experimental, but this feature will attempt to predict the word you're trying to write, and similar with the spell checking, it will try to mimic your handwriting style. And truthfully, these writing aids features are not really that helpful for me on their current state, and I don't know about you, but it gives me a little bit of anxiety when I see that red underline, and I think this adds an unnecessary friction when taking down notes or journaling. So one of the major updates of the app is the AI integration, and the previous new features I have discussed so far are subtle usage of AI. But if you prefer typing and you want to integrate the AI-assisted typing feature, tap the keyboard icon in the navigation bar and then type as you usually do. To use the new features, select the phrases or sentences and then select the stars icon. You can improve the grammar and fix words that were misspelled. You can also paraphrase it. You can also change the tone to professional, friendly, or confident. And with the help of AI, you can also make the selection longer or shorter. But right now, this feature is still at its early stage of development and it's not really on par with the other available AI tools in the market yet. So if you want to really use an AI to fix the grammar or spelling, paraphrase, change tones, or something like that, you're better off using other tools available for free on the internet, and they are far better than what is GoodNotes 6 is offering right now. Also, if you're using the AI assisted typing feature, you have to be connected to the internet to use it. On the same vein of AI integrated features, you can go to the Marketplace tab in the library view and you will see this interactive exam prep courses. I have tried the SAT math prep course, which is free on the app, and the idea and the goal is great, but when solving math problems, it is nice to know if you are on the right track of solving the problem, but right now, the AI feature is not the best yet, and I understand that it is still on its beginning stages, and it will improve, but right now, it is too clunky, and there are different ways of solving a math problem, and because it prompts you when it detects that your process is not the same as it expects, if you're not confident with your process, you will question your ability even though your process is correct. It will alert you that something is wrong, and I don't know about you, but that breaks the flow sometimes, especially if you are already deep into it. But I have to say, these free exam prep courses are helpful whether you will take the actual exam or you just want to refresh your knowledge. And once you have downloaded the prep exam courses, you can access them again from the Documents tab and in wherever location you have stored them in. And a special mention, which is not really an important update, but I would just like to mention this, but the new icon of the app is really the best yet and just so beautiful, and I just want to say that here. With the new features that are now available in GoodNotes 6, the question now is if it is worth it to upgrade. And right now, with its current state, I don't think it is worth it. The price jump from a one-time purchase of $7.99 to $29.99 or $9.99 per year subscription-based payment is pretty big. But they are offering discounts right now, so make sure to check those out if you are interested on upgrading. Although the state of the current features are in its beginning stages, I hope great improvements are on the works and we'll see how it will turn out. Let me know about what you think on the new features of the GoodNotes 6 app in the comment section below, and see you next time. Bye!